Japanese chisels come in a variety of different sizes, all suited to different scale work. If you're a furniture maker or box maker, you're probably familiar with the Oire Nomi, or the Japanese bench chisel, which is 210 mils long and really nicely sized for any work that's been going to be done on top of a workbench. However, if you are working on structural carpentry, and in the West we're becoming very familiar with Japanese carpentry, you probably want a larger chisel. So this is a Tataki Nomi, 30 centimeters long, a good step up in size, also a good step up in heft and cross section, which means it can take a very big hit, is designed to take a very big hit, and also with a longer blade can be used to reference larger timbers when doing joinery. This is pretty much a carpenter's tool rather than a furniture maker's tool in Japan, because once you start swinging one of these on top of a workbench, you start working very high. However, there are structures that require timber much larger than something like that. So what do you use when you're building a very large structure in a very large section? You use a very large chisel. So these are the Anaya Nomi, and these are pretty much the exclusive domain of carpenters working in very, very big sections. They are really, really beautifully finished, these examples, and there's a couple of nice things about them. One is that the neck is cranked up above the plane of the bottom of the cutting head. So when you are referencing really big timbers, you can actually reference all the way past that edge, and even as you work all the way down into a joint, that neck doesn't foul on the timber above. There is also the Tsuki Nomi. Longer again in the head and much longer in the handle than the Anaya Nomi. And they are brilliantly done because when you reference them on a surface that you'd like to pair, this neck is cranked such that the handle does not foul. And when you're working with tools of this size and this heft, momentum is on your side. The inertia of the tool itself with a sharp edge really takes a lot of stopping. So working with these is really an experience. Sharpening them is also an experience, and we'll do a separate video on that. However, if you are looking at doing some really large joinery and trying your hand at some Japanese carpentry, then these are a really nice tool to add to the collection. Hope you enjoy them.